Hi sir, my name is Mona Krishnan. I am from 3BMMA Section 1 Group 1. My team consists of 5 members who are Ansel, Jackson, John, Boone, Melina and I. Now we want to explain about the Lab 2 Master Cylinder Inspection, Removal and Refitting. The lab objective is to inspect the condition of master cylinder assembled, to replace parts of master cylinder assembled, and to name all parts of master cylinder assembled. Let's see the assemble and disassemble of master cylinder video.
First and foremost, we need to dismantle the nuts to open the master cylinder. So we need to open the cable first. This one, this cable, and this nut need to be opened. So that's all. Remove the big fluid. So we need to open the cover lid first. And then we need to use the screwdriver to open the lid, and then we need to suck the back fluid.
Run to the brake. We will use the 14 millimeter common ring wrench. Then we will open this cable. We will open this master cylinder. We kita pisahkanlah dari master cylinder. Gunakan wrench 12 mm.
Diaphragm. So what you can find, although it's crooked, but it's still in good condition because it doesn't have any tear area. So it's actually good condition, although it's crooked.
Ini okay, kita solve. The master cylinder housing is in condition good, and the master reservoir also in condition good. This is the master cylinder piston. This is the first piston, that's the second piston. In isolation, the master cylinder condition is good. First one is good. The second piston also in condition good. And then this is the master oil level, master cylinder fruit oil, a breakfruit oil sensor. This sensor also in condition good. Master cylinder is orange. There are two orange. These two orange condition good. Not bad. Okay, the safety pin of the master cylinder piston in good condition. Let's see the condition of the O-ring. This is the first piston and this is the second piston. For the first piston, the first O-ring is in condition good and the second O-ring also in the condition good. For the second piston, the first O-ring also in condition good and the second O-ring also in condition good.
The inner surface of the master cylinder, as you can see here, it is in good condition as well. So,
brake booster in condition good, not
good morning, sir. I am Bon Vicente from BMMS S11 and I will present the question 1 for my group, which is, based on your finding, what is the effect of push rod end length to brake performance? If the push rod end length is too short, it will cause not enough braking force even we fully press the brake pedal, and the push rod may cannot push the master cylinder to go deeper when we further press the brake pedal. And this is very dangerous because when a vehicle is moving very fast, not enough braking force will cause the vehicle cannot stop in the shortest time and will cause the accident to happen. If the push rod end length is too long, it will cause too much braking force even we slightly press the brake pedal, and the brake will lock the wheel easily even we slightly press the brake pedal, and this also will make the passenger in the vehicle not comfortable. And this is also really dangerous in wet condition road because the brake can lock the wheel easily and will make the vehicle to lose control. So in general, the ideal push rod end length is when we out depress the brake pedal, it should be in 9.65 mm to 9.90 mm. So in our experiment finding, we found that the when we now press the brake pedal, the push rod end length is 10.4 mm and when we depress the brake pedal, the push rod end length is 38.3 mm. So as a conclusion, the push rod end length for the experiment vehicle is too long. So that is from me. Thank you.
Good day. Today I'm going to discuss about question 2 lecture. Name type of brake oil used for your car. Can different type of brake oil be used and why? So type of car is Nissan Almera 1.5 liter, and type of brake fluid is used brake fluid but for Nissan only. No, this is because different car manufacturers have the original brake fluid being verified. Dot 3 and dot 4 brake fluid is a mineral based fluid. Dot 5 is silicon based. When brake fluid is wrongly used, thus it may turn out poor lubrication, overheating, and possibly transmission failure. Thank you.
Dr. Zahid, I'm Juiz Wan from BMMA S1/1. Today I will be presenting this lab 2 master cylinder inspection removal and refitting question 3. So for the question is name hydraulic tubes that connected to the master cylinder and where all tubes are connected. So the name of the hydraulic tubes that are connected to the master cylinder are the brake fluid line. So the where are all the tubes are connected is from the primary pistons, it's to the rear brake, and secondary pistons to the front brake. So for the brake fluid line, as you can see from the lab session that my group do, this is the primary pistons inside the master cylinder to the this tube of brake fluid line for the first primary pistons. So for the secondary piston is on the back, so this is the back. So this is for the secondary pistons brake fluid line that it goes to the front brake. So this is the master cylinder diagram that it's inner part. So this brake pedal that will be pressed and the pistons will push the hydraulic fluid brake fluid to the brake fluid line. So this is the primary piston and secondary piston. So this is the primary piston that will goes to the rear brake, and this is secondary pistons that goes to the front brake. That's all for me. Thank you.
Hello everyone, my name is Hansel Charles and I am from 3BMMA S1/1. So today I'm going to present about the question number 4. The question is, what is the function of diaphragm? So normally the diaphragm is located inside the brake booster. The function of diaphragm is to separate the two chambers in the brake booster. One of the chambers is linked to the brake pedal and the other to the master cylinder. Once the pedal is pressed, a rod is pushed into a housing which contains two springs and an air filter. The air begins to flood one side of the servo body, then remains inside in the sump connected to the air intake or hydraulic pump, creating a pressure difference between the two chambers. The diaphragm also helps to increase the force against the master cylinder piston when the brake pedal is pressed. A rod attached to the brake pedal assembly runs through the center of the diaphragm on its way to the master cylinder piston. As the rod transfers the force applied to the brake pedal, the diaphragm also pulls on the rod and increases the force against the master cylinder piston. So these two combined forces will slow down the vehicle quickly and also easily. So that's all from me. Thank you very much.
Mr. Jason, I'm from BMMA, S1/1. So now I would like to present about the conversion of the Lab 2 master cylinder. So for this For this conclusion, in this lab activity, we learn to inspect the condition of master cylinder assembly, replace parts of master cylinder assembly according to the procedures, and name all parts of master cylinder assembly. So, next, we learn how to use the equipment and theory behind the brake system, for example, how it works and functions. Last but not least, we learn to cooperate with our team members so that everyone of us learn theory and hands-on together as a team. Thank you for me.